Yeah.
those are nice. So where'd you get those, man?
I just... Thank you very much for being here. Oh, I'm sorry. Do you like my boots?
I do. Can I keep them? I need a backup pair.
Can you believe that your boots...
I need one in Iowa and one in New Hampshire, so you gotta give me that.
Why is that a big deal that you wore these? I love these boots, by the way. And,
yeah.
And people made a big deal that you had heels on your boots. Who cares? These are great boots, by the way. These are Florsheim.
Yeah, I only wear them on weekends.
You only wear them on weekends?
Yeah, nights mostly.
You wear them to bed, yeah?
Yeah, the truth is, they're a step up. When I was in college, I bought some boots like that, and I remember the old foam parties? Remember that? You don't remember that.
Yeah, foam party?
Yeah, yeah. So I bought some of those, and when I left the foam party, they were white. Because the foam, like, washed the dye out of it. It was really bad. So these are like a step up.
You used to go to those dance parties?
I went one time.
You can't say that you go to them all the time. You went once.
Yeah, well, that's all you need. They ruined my boots. So
but I think they're cool. My dad wore these zipper boots to work. He worked at IBM. And I was, I got into them and I started wearing them too. And I know Will Ferrell loves zipper boots too. And we used to just wear them around the office. Like, yeah. But Will would wear white ones. White zipper
because he went to a phone party.
That's probably why. But I think you should still wear them. Have you stopped wearing them?
No, they're in an undisclosed location, but they'll be used at the appropriate time.
Undisclosed location. You can't say where they're hiding. Yeah. I think you should bring them back out. Don't let people bully you, man. They look cool. There's fashion forward. You're Marco Rubio. You can do whatever you want to do. You're running for president. They're all wrong. We're all wrong. Welcome to our show, and thank you for being here. I appreciate it. New York City has a special meaning for you.
Yeah.
Because?
I got engaged here.
Yeah. What's the story behind that?
It was like a long time ago, but it was, but it was good. It was a good thing.
So, yeah.
So we came here on Valentine's Day in 1997, and I told my wife, I wanted to propose to her on top of the Empire State Building. She liked Sleepless in Seattle. Was that the name of it?
Sure, yeah.
And, I thought it was about insomnia, but it's not. It's like a...
No, that's where they get you. Yeah,
so she didn't want to... It was cold, and she didn't want to go up there to the top, so I had to figure out quickly, like, how am I going to get up there? So
she wanted to go to the top of the Empire State?
No, it was cold. You know, we're from Florida, so, like, it was, like, 40s. Oh, my God.
That's not even cold, yeah.
Right, so we want to go up there, so I finally convinced her. I said, look, as a child, I always loved King Kong. Remember King Kong was on top of the building? She's like, that's not even a real story. I go, I know, but I liked it. Let's go. So I got her up there. I proposed. And then I was afraid, I don't know why, it was this thing. I thought she was gonna drop the ring off the side, so I grabbed the ring back, and then I gave it back to her when we got to the bottom. But I was just worried I would lose the ring. Like, it would fall off the side, you're not gonna find it.
Just don't go to the Empire State Building, though. This is like...
I know, but that's where they made Sleepless in Seattle. They should have done it out by, somewhere flatter.
You just gotta start renting other movies, yeah. But...